Salutations friends, welcome back to my channel. Today's just gonna be a little talking video, a little chit chat video. I don't do these as often as I'd like, and I always like chatting with you guys. So I figured I'd share some things that I'm working on and also some exciting news for me. And if you follow my Instagram, you probably know what I'm gonna talk about, but I'll save that closer to the end. So yeah. Really bad at these like vlog talking things. I'm really good at talking to myself, do not get me wrong, but I always like have things I want to talk to you guys about, and then when I sit down in front of you guys, I'm like my mind just gets erased, so I'm really sorry. But I wanted to say thank you first and foremost to, I got a lot of love on my passion project post or video. You guys seem really excited about that. That's really awesome. Thank you, guys. I try and give you guys updates to that project every month, but I don't want it to be inorganic. I don't want to be forced to talk to you guys about a stage in that product if it's not ready to be talked about. The beauty of that series is going to be me organically sharing the journey with you, and I'm not going to rush anything with that. Tentatively, by this time next year, the fragrance should hopefully be ready for launch. Because I'm one person doing it, and it is kind of a side project, I'm not rushing through it. And I've also never created a fragrance before. Not like this. I mean, we've all mixed our own oils, mixed our own blends and stuff like that, but I don't know how long it usually takes. I don't know if a year is the right amount of time. Maybe it should be longer. There's also other places I can go and give them my formula and have them make it. I'm figuring out the best way to do this with the best ingredients with the lowest cost in mind. So everything is just, it's a process, it's a fun process, and I really enjoy it, but it's something that definitely will happen when it happens, so I will have those videos. Maybe I'll do like a little update to let you guys know what's going on once a month, but the real beef of those videos will happen when it just happens. So it'd probably be one every 2 to 3 months. So yeah, that's kind of that. I'm still working on it. I've worn the fragrance a bit. I really am enjoying it personally. But there are definitely things that I need to change, so I'm excited to tweak and work on those as well. So yeah, there's that. What else? Let's see. I wanted to share with you guys, if you guys follow me on Instagram, you know what I'm going to talk about next. Okay, if you guys know, one of my favorite male YouTube reviewers is Super Dacob. I love his channel. I love how passionate he takes, how obsessed and just knowledgeable he is about luxury, specifically about fragrances. He has a passion and appreciation for the artistry and the opulence that goes behind a lot of these super high-end designer clothing, gossip behind the designers, on top of like jewelry, accessories, and fragrance. I love his taste in fragrance. So one of his favorite fragrances, which is one of my favorite fragrances, I've been in love with this for a while, but I'd forgotten about it because it was a little, not that it was out of my price range, but it was just something that was always around. So when Chanel released that they were going to be getting rid of their Eau de Toilette and their less exclusive lines, I was devastated. I'm not going to get too much into the where, when, what, how, who. I'm going to actually sometime this week devote an entire video to that, just because I feel like it deserves a video. And Super Dacob, Dacob talks about it a lot. I'll link his channel below if you're interested. But basically, they just reformulated a lot of their old fragrances, and they only have it available as Eau de Parfums, no longer as Eau de Toilettes. And again, I'm still doing a little bit more research on it, but they changed not just the formula and the concentration, they changed the fragrances. Like, every single one of the fragrances just smells different. It's a different experience. And in some cases, like Cough Cough number 18, which I love, it wasn't too much of a shift where I'm not worried about it. But some fragrances, like the one I'm going to show you, it was such a change that they are completely different fragrances. And it's a big deal. I mean, a lot of people love these fragrances. They're very expensive fragrances. A lot of them have a cult following. And so the fact that they are completely changed but still being marketed as these fragrances, people are upset. They think Chanel's greedy, that they're just using the Eau de Parfums to get more money. I could go into the nose behind it, everything. Again, I'm working on a whole video, so I'm trying to be kind of vague. Because I want to make sure I get my facts straight and my dates, because I always get dates wrong whenever I talk about things like this. I'm off by a few years or a few months. So one of the reformulations that I hated, I don't hate, but I dislike. So one of the formulations that, or one of the fragrances that I was in love with, I had never gotten around to getting it. I had samples. I still have samples of it. I think I have one sample left. And I was just kind of like, I don't need to buy it because I don't wear it that often, but I loved it. And then when I learned about this, and specifically that this one was completely butchered, I went on a hunt. Now, I am weird about buying certain fragrances online from specific websites. I'm going to go do an entire series, it's probably going to start next week or the week after before Mother's Day, where I give you guys my favorite places to buy discounted or wholesale-esque price or tester fragrances from specific websites. And each video is going to be one website. I'm going to go in depth. What I love about them, what I don't love about it, why I trust them, the best buys from there and the worst buys. I'm really going to try and make this a series, especially if you guys are looking to buy luxury fragrances or niche fragrances and you don't want to spend pay full price. There are ways that you don't have to, but that series requires a lot of research and I want to make sure that I'm doing it properly. So with this specific one, I was very like, I wanted to get it from Chanel if possible. And one of you guys actually contacted me on Instagram and we were talking and you're like, look at the site. And I couldn't get it from Europe. The United States site was like, no. I contacted them. I called. So whatever. So I was at the mall yesterday and we were at Town Center. If you know, some of you guys live in my area. You guys know I live in Fort Lauderdale. Our mall, my mall is Galleria. It's a little bit of an upscale mall. It has a few upscale shops, but it's small. And then the two next malls, like sandwiched between us, are Aventura. And that mall is ginormous and it has everything. It's one of the biggest malls in the area. It has like one of the biggest Sephora's. It has all of their department stores have everything. Like I could go there and try every fragrance ever. They have everything there. The problem is I hate driving there. And I, without going too into it, I avoid it at all costs. So generally I go to Town Center, which is the Boca Mall, which is the Boca Town Center Mall. And that's a luxury mall. It has a Saks, a Bloomingdale's, a Neiman Marcus, a Nordstrom's, has a Gucci boutique, a separate Gucci boutique, a separate Louis Vuitton boutique, you know, a separate Versace boutique. It's big. It's not as luxe as the Gardens Mall, but it's pretty luxe. And so they have a nice selection of boutiques there. Specifically, what I like going there is they have a higher end or a better fragrance selection. So they have a Chanel boutique there, and we were there, just my husband and I were just getting lunch and just walking around, and I was like, I need to go see if they have this. And he's like, what? I'm like, give me a minute. So I ran to the, not ran, I obviously jaunted or trolloped or galloped. Walked fast, but not fast. And I don't know what I'm trying to say, I'm sorry. Till I got to the Saks that has the Chanel boutique. It has all of the cosmetics and all of the fragrances, everything. They have a little area where you can test all the fragrances and see what you like. It's really a fun experience if you ever have the chance to try. I need to know if you guys have any more of the Eau de Toilettes. And she was like, oh my gosh. She's like, no, we have Eau de Parfums. And then we were talking for a few minutes. I was like, oh no. And then there was another lady there that had overheard us. And she's like, wait, are you asking about the Eau de Toilettes? I'm like, yes. She's like, we have them in the back room, whatever's left. And we are going to be sending them back Monday. Which ones are you looking for? I can see if we have them. And I was like, oh, I was like, I have a lunch. We have to go to lunch. I'm like, these are the ones I'm looking for. I gave her a list of like 4 or 5 of them. And I'm like, I will buy whatever of these you have. And she's like, okay. So I'm like, I will be back after lunch. So we went to lunch and we came back and she's like, I'm so sorry. I was like, no. She's like, we only had one. And I was like, which one? And it was the one that I wanted more than any of the other ones. And I was like, yes. I'm like, okay. Thank you so much for going through the effort and holding aside for me. But it was the one that I wanted. This was the one that I specifically was hoping for. But if they had any others, I would have gotten them too. So I will share that with you. And again, I'm going to share this in my haul. But I figured, again, I'd share with you this thing that I got that I'm really excited for. Yes, I got Sycamore and an EDT. Oh my goodness, you guys have no idea how much I love this. I mean, obviously, if you guys are all fragrance, you know you have that fragrance. This is such a beautiful fragrance. If you like the woodiness of what you can sometimes get from a Molecule One, this is kind of like the luxe, higher end, mysterious, more depth version of that. Just what I get on my skin. I'm not saying that they are all the same fragrances. This to me is just one of the fragrances that's in its own league. There are a few fragrances like that for me that are just like you can't compare, but I try to tell you guys what's popular to give you a good idea of what this reminds me of in case you've never experienced this. Now, the Eau de Toilette version, I'm going to do an entire review on this, so I'm not going to get too much into longevity, wear timer notes. I'm just going to give you the brief difference between the Eau de Parfum and the Eau de Toilette that I pick up in my nose. With the, I'm going to put this down because my hands are gross and I don't want to drop it because I tend to drop things. Knowing me, I drop it and shatter it and just need to see me cry, ugly cry. The Eau de Parfum isn't a bad fragrance, but I don't, when you think about the beauty of Sycamore in an Eau de Toilette, you think of this beautiful, smoky, wood, slightly green, mysterious fragrance, and it's just captivating. It's absolutely captivating. The Eau de Parfum version of it is like this dumbed down version, and there's like no smoke in it. There's like all wood, and I usually love wood fragrances, but the beauty in this to me is in those smoky notes mixed with those woody notes mixed with a little bit of spice. It's just a gorgeous fragrance. And so, like, I was sitting there like smelling the Eau de Parfum. I'm like, I remembered sampling it a while ago, like maybe like a month or two ago, and being like, eh. And I'm just sitting there like, because they have it on these like long sticks that you pull out and smell, and then you spritz it on a card. So I spritz it on the card, and it's just, it's nothing compared to this, at least in my opinion. Now, I know some people who have never experienced the Eau de Toilette love the Eau de Parfum, and if you love the Eau de Parfum, that's awesome. But I feel sad that you've never experienced the Eau de Toilette. It's really a fantastic fragrance. It's one of my absolute favorites. I've been on the hunt for it for a while, and I'm kind of bummed that I hadn't bought it. Like, she only had one. See, the thing is, since I asked about Beige, Coromandel, there's a few others. I forget exactly which ones I asked, because I just kind of listed off the top of my head. A number 18. Now, the thing with number 18 is number 18, again, like I said previously, the Eau de Toilette and the Eau de Parfum are similar. You can get around getting the Eau de Parfum. You really can with that one, at least that's my opinion. And a lot of people don't appreciate number 18. It's a beauty, but it is definitely not anything like any other Chanel fragrance. I'll get into that in the future because I love that perfume. But this just fragrance, Sycamore, you guys, this was just like, this made my day yesterday. I was smiling all day. And my essay was very generous. They gave me a whole bunch of samples of fragrances that I hadn't tried the Eau de Parfum formulation. They're like, here, take them, try them. Here's my card. Come back, buy more. Thank you. But they were just very nice. And we actually talked about number 18 for like a few minutes. He's like, oh my gosh, are you serious? Like we were talking about how like alienistic and unnatural and bizarre and beautiful it was. It's like cold. It's like, there's something cold about it, but it's still very beautiful. Like, oh my gosh, I love that fragrance. But Sycamore, this was like the find for me. I was so excited. So if you guys follow my Instagram, you probably just saw me like, here's a picture of the perfumes and like getting really excited and talking about it. So you probably already know about this and oh my gosh, I'm talking about it forever, but that's fine. So yeah, so Sycamore, I'm so happy. And I almost like want to buy a second bottle if I can find it, because if I run out of this, I will be devastated. I don't know. So yeah, anyway, that's my holy grail. One of my holy grail. I have a few. I'm going to do an entire video on my holy grail fragrances. These are fragrances that I'm either going to purchase or have purchased that are like holy grail cannot live without. Oh my gosh, this was one of them, and I finally got it, and I'm very excited. So yeah, I'm gonna stop babbling now. Okay, so yeah, I talked about my channel, talked about Sycamore and what I'm the reviews I'm gonna do with it and the other videos surrounding it. Now, just to remind you guys, this is just a reminder. I'm gonna link the link below. The last vlog I did, which is where you enter, is for the international giveaway. This is the thank you for reaching 1,000 subscriber milestone giveaway. If you don't remember, I was unable to include international subscribers in the first giveaway, and so I said once I figured out the logistics of shipping fragrances and hazardous materials overseas, I was going to have a giveaway just for the international subscribers. That is still going on. April 20th is the deadline. I'm going to pick a winner and announce it. So anyway, a winner will be announced on April probably 21st or 22nd, depending on when I get the video up. But a winner will be chosen on the 20th, and you will be notified on the 20th. So thanks again, by the way, for 1,000 subscribers, and I think I broke 1,300. I'm still in shock. Still, thank you guys. You were amazing. Thank you. I love you all. My husband's still like, I can't believe you talk in front of a camera. You like are a clam in person. Anyway, so that's the, again, just reminding you guys, please enter. Remember, you have to be a subscriber. I have to see that you are a subscriber, which means if your subscribers are hidden or your channels you are subscribed to are hidden, I cannot verify that you are a subscriber and I cannot have enter you into the contest. So I'm going to be choosing April 20th. I don't know if you would want to change your subscriber for me to be able to see, for anyone to have them active for just a day, so that you can enter. But do remember, if I cannot see that you're a subscriber and I check, you will not be entered. So just remember that, keep that in mind. That is one of the rules. I have to be able to verify that you are a subscriber. Just a real quick rehash the rules. You have to be a subscriber. I have to be able to see that you are a subscriber. You have to enter by commenting on that video your top three favorite fragrances and what you love most about fragrances or the fragrance community or things like that, which was the same thing you had to do in the original giveaway. And the prize is a bottle of light blue from Dolce & Gabbana and an MCM candle. And again, I will happily ship that out to any place in the world. However, if there are any duties or taxes or anything involved with that, you are responsible. So in entering, you think that is okay if you have to pay any duties or customs fees, but everything else I'm paying for. So, you know, it might be a few bucks. I don't know how your country works or customs fees works, but do keep that in mind when you enter. If that is an issue and you've already entered, just reply underneath your entry saying I'm pulling my entry because I don't want to pay any duties or customs fees if I win. But that is what happens with international shipping, because Lord knows I paid crazy international fees. I am fast needing a cup of coffee. I've woken up, put on my makeup, got dressed, turned on my camera, and realized I haven't had my cup of coffee, and I think that's the problem. So I'm ending this here. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this very rambling, random video. Mostly me talking about this beautiful fragrance because I could talk about this for hours. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you like my vloggy, talky videos, specifically when I talk about fragrance and channel updates and just kind of go off on crazy tangents that make absolutely no sense, remember to give this video a thumbs up. It lets me know to continue doing videos like this. And also don't forget to subscribe, because it's free and I'm free, and I put out new videos every Monday through Friday and sometimes on the weekends as well, so I'll always have something for you to watch. And in case, I hope you guys are all happy and healthy and have a great day, month, year, whatever, and I'll see you next time. Bye!